Good day! Welcome to my YouTube channel. Today, we are going to study about opposition and triangulation as endgame principle. Opposition is when a king enforces the opponent to move sideways or backwards using that strategy to push forward and promote pawns. Or in the other way, when king in an inferior position trying to achieve a draw position. Triangulation is when king can maneuver on the three squares in a form of a triangle while the opposing king only has two such squares. Therefore, in principle, whoever gets more square to move backwards or sidesteps gets the opposition. We have two diagrams here. We study first the first diagram as I put in the original position of the king. As you can see, king is ahead of one pawn and he has pawn at c6 and a5, while the black king has pawn at a6 and position at c7 square. The only way for, actually there's two ways to win here. One is to be able to promote the pawn, and the other way is to be able for the white king to get to b6 square to capture the a6 pawn. Let's start, which is the only move is king d5. For black, the only move is king c8 to wait for white's next move. Just in case the king goes to d6, now you see an opposition move, which is king d8. Opposition moves prevents king, the white king, from going to e7 or the other way around, or a pawn pushes to c7 that will not prevent the pawn from promoting, or will prevent the pawn from promoting. So as you can see, if I move this, king c8 is a draw. So let us go back to the original position after king d5. Only way is king c8, but if black made a mistake, king d8, then white gets the opposition. So a must for black to go to the side ways. If just in case it goes to king c8, push c7, king d7, king d7, and if the move is king to a7, the only way to win here is by promoting this to rook. So king b7, rook c6. Now if the king goes to b8, obviously the pawn is free already to capture by the rook, so king must protect it. Then if white will move to king c8, king a8, then rook a6 check and wins. This is one way of winning. The other way to win is by triangulation, to be able to capture the pawn at a6 by, if the king goes backwards, just step backwards. Now we are doing triangulation. For example, he steps up. Now white gets the opposition. The king is forced to go down. Then king gets into b6, capturing the pawn at a6, which is two pawns already, and it's much easier to win. Now, if we go back again to the original position here, so, and then king c8 backwards, say like the king doesn't want to go up because white king will get the opposition. So king d8, king d4, of course king cannot go to c7 because it's the same scenario. So king c8, now we get the triangulation, which is the triangle move. If you notice, there's triangle move like that. That's what you call triangulation. And the king has no triangulation because that's the only he has. Because if once he steps into this square c7, white gets the opposition. So the only move is king d8. Now white gets the opposition. Only move is same scenario. If it's king e8, then this pawn promotes. We go back again, king c8, same scenario as I shown you a while ago. So I hope you learned something about this opposition and triangulation strategy, because this is very important. It always happen on king and pawn ending. And I want you to practice this, get your chessboard, and make your way to study this, most especially pawn endings, king's endings are so important. Now we go to our next diagram. So we notice that king here at f3 is protecting the pawn at g4, while the black king is at e8. Now the motive of white here is to promote that g pawn, but to find ways he must oppose the king. Black must try to oppose the white king too, but seems like whatever white king does, black king gets always the opposition. Let me show you how amazing this endgame. If king f4, black king just simply go to f1. I'm sorry, f8. If the king goes forward, black gets the opposition. If king goes to the g5 square, black gets the opposition. Anytime black gets the opposition like that, it's a draw. King here, then don't go sideways, otherwise you lose. Always oppose. So if he pushes the pawn, then it's same scenario. Go backward, same scenario. Same scenario. Now we go to the original position. Now what about the king goes here? King just go sideways. If the king goes here, king just go sideways. Don't go up, otherwise white gets the opposition. Then you are forced to go sideways. If you go to the right, now he gets to push the pawn. You go here, now he pushes the pawn. You go here, now he pushes the pawn. Then you go here. He pushed the pawn. He go here, he pushed the pawn. Then he was able to promote it, and it's a win. Same scenario on this position, where we go to this variation. So after this variation here, king h4, just don't move up. Always always go this level. Don't always go to the seventh rank level. Always goes off. If white goes forward, now you get the opposition. If goes here, you get the opposition. If goes here, if goes backward, now obviously it's a draw because you are moving forward towards the pawn and the king is backwards. If the king goes to f4, you get the opposition. How amazing this position is, that too many squares the white king can maneuver but can't do anything. How amazing black opposition can do. He just moves sideways here, sideways here, sideways, and white can't do anything. I'm glad that I was able to get this example to be able to show you how powerful opposition is and also triangulation. I hope you learned a lot from this example and show it to your friends. Keep on studying endgame because game is a very important part of chess playing. So thank you so much and keep watching. God bless. Thank you.